Testing, testing. Testing from Max Baer Park in Livermore, California. Getting ready to present our featured game this evening, which is a rematch, actually, of a game that happened earlier in the week, featuring the East Regional Champions from New Jersey and the host team from Danville, California. We'll be back in a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Livermore, California, and Max Baer Park. On behalf of your host, California District 57, we are proud to present the 2017 Little League Intermediate World Series. Today's game features the East champions from Freehold Township Little League in Freehold, New Jersey. And the host team, District 57 from Danville, California. Now, if you'd please help me welcome the umpire crew, the volunteer umpires for tonight's ball game. Behind the plate, Mr. David Wooldridge. At first base, Mr. Tim McCullough. At second base, Mr. Jonathan Hagen. At third base, Mr. Tony Calcagno. In left field, Mr. Doug Pfaffenberger. And in right field, Mr. Donald Escudero. And now for the players. From Freehold, New Jersey, number 16, John Abrahamson. Number 6, Patrick Burns. Number 5, J.J. Donahue. Number 8, Zach Gorman. Number 11, Michael Mancusi. Number 12, Connor Marie. Number 18, Jonathan Olick. Number 10, Connor Quinn. Number 1, Mario Rivera. Number 14, Brad Salamone. Number 13, Jace Shapiro. Number 2, Anthony Sirico. And your manager, Jeff Gorman. Coach, Vinny Sirico. And coach, Mike Mancusi. And now for the home team from Danville, California, District 57. Number 17, Matthew Abbas. Number 10, Tyler Ofdahl. Number 18, Blake Alameda. Number 5, Evan Belingett. Number 19, Tyler Beach. Number 6, Cole Bosha. Number 7, Calvin Chang. Number 2, Ty Clausen. Number 16, Noah Garcia. Number 8, Andrew Gaskill. Number 9, James Murray. Number 1, Chris White. Number 11, Tyler Wood. Their manager, Jim Grant. Coach, John Frisch. And coach, Bob Orr. Now, if you would all rise, remove your hats and face center field. We will invite Kevin Patel to do the national anthem for us. Kevin Patel grew up playing baseball and focusing on academics. Nowadays, he spends his time exploring the limitless avenue of sound through music. He returns this year to the 2017 50-70 Little League Intermediate World Series to play for you the United States National Anthem. Kevin. All right, players, your dugouts. We're going to have the first pitch. Chris Van Schaak, please come onto the field. Throwing out the first pitch today will be Chris Van Schaak, the deputy superintendent for the Livermore School District. The school district has been a proud partner of Granada Little League for many years and has been generous in providing the field space located right behind us. Chris has been with the district for 24 years and has been a strong supporter of baseball. He was actively involved with Granada Little League as a manager and a field construction volunteer for 9 seasons. Chris was also involved in international baseball himself when, as a college player, he was a member of the first United States baseball team to play in mainland China. Chris, it is all yours. Nicely done. Now, if the managers would meet with the umpires at home plate.
Testing. Good evening, folks, and welcome to California, Livermore, California, in fact, at Max Baer Park, getting ready for our featured matchup tonight. And it's a rematch of a game that happened earlier in the week where the host team beat the East 3-2, so the East is looking for some revenge. The winner of this game moves on to the United States Championship game, which will be held Saturday at 5 p.m. and televised on ESPN3. I'm joined again by Mr. Rick Rude. He was with me last night for a very exciting game between the West Champs of Hawaii and the host team. Rick, it's great to have you back. I know this is a huge, exciting game for the folks around here tonight, and I'm expecting nothing but less than a great game.
This is going to be huge, and it's going to be another exciting game tonight. I can feel it. Both these teams, hallmark of excellent defense. Like you said, the last time these two met, Sunday, score was 3-2. District 57 has gone out and consistently held all their opponents this tournament to less than 3. So same with the East. East has come through, held their opponents to low scores as well. I'm really excited to see Tyler Beach out there on the mound tonight. He is, I don't know if you can have a favorite, my favorite pitcher on District 57. Watching him is fantastic. He's got that left-handed thing going on. And we're going to see some action over at first base tonight, I'm sure, as well.
Yeah, absolutely. Tyler Beach came in that game, that Sunday game, and did a great job of shutting down this East team. And he's looking to do that again. So Jim Grant's boys are ready to go. I know Mr. Gorman over on the east side is also ready to go. They've been looking forward to this game all day.
Also a little bit of history on the line tonight. Should District 57 move into the finals, it'll be the first time that a host team has moved into the finals here.
Leading off the top of the first inning for New Jersey, number 8, Zachary Gorman.
Yep, so we're back in Livermore now, and leading off for New Jersey is going to be Zach Gorman. Fouls off. Second offering. The count is 0-2. That ball misses, and it's 1-2. I might be way down. Ball's fouled out of play. Zach Gorman's struggling with the plate a little bit in this series. He's only batting 0-9-1. 11 at bats with only one hit. So he's looking to break out a little bit. He's going to be our starting pitcher tonight. And he throws pretty hard. So
I was watching him in the bullpen over there, and he was firing bullets over there. So it's going to be exciting to watch him as well.
And that's a called strike three, and that's how the game starts, with a strikeout of Zach Gorman. Going to bring to the plate center fielder number 13, Jay Shapiro.
Beach has got such a smooth delivery, just makes it look like nothing. Fastball right down the middle.
Floater outside that misses. The count is 1-1. Jace has one hit in the World Series, and it was a big one. It was a two-run home run that I hit against Florida, I believe. So chopper up the middle, back to the pitcher. Tall Beach is able to corral it and throw over to Garcia at first, and that's the second out of the inning.
And that's where it helps to be the tallest player on your team right there.
That's right. It's going to bring to the plate the shortstop, number 6, Patrick Burns.
Now batting the shortstop, number 6, Patrick Burns.
So the first two batters have been retired in this game, and the first two batters have been struggling offensively for the East all tournament. However, Patrick Burns is not one of them. Pat's batting 300 in the tournament. He's got 3 hits in 10 at-bats, all singles, and scored 2 runs. One's off the fist, and it's going to drop over the second baseman's head into right field, and that's the first hit of the game for Freehold Township Little League. And now that's going to bring to the plate the cleanup batter, Jonathan Olick, playing left field tonight. And, Rick, this is the recipes for success for the East is the top three guys getting on base and then the power coming to the plate in batters like Olick, Abrahamson, Morey. So the key for the host team is to keep those top two or three guys off the base. in front of those big batters. Olick's batting 400 for the series. He's 4 for 10. He scored 3 runs, and he's got an RBI. The star of the East offense so far in the World Series, John Abrahamson, is on deck. And Jim Grant and the host team would like nothing more than for him to be leading off next inning. So there's 2 outs with a runner at first base and an 0-1 count on Jonathan Olick. The ball misses up, and the count is 1-1.
Burns over on first, respecting the left-handed pitcher, taking just a modest lead.
Ball's popped straight up, right behind us and out of play. The one thing, if you recall, Rick, when we were watching Tyler Beach pitch in that last game early in the week, was how effective he was at keeping runners close to the bag at first base. He's got a really good pickoff move. He's got lots of different options. He's got a snap throw, he slide step. So he's a true pitcher. He's not just a power thrower. That ball misses on the outside, so the count is now 2-2. So I think that as long as Beach is in the game, it's possible the East running game will be kept in check. 2-2, off-speed pitch is pulled foul. Well, there's a lot of pressure on these kids tonight, Rick. This is amazing.
It is. And it's been a fantastic tournament, and you know, no one wants to see it end, but unfortunately one of these teams is going to be bowing out tonight. Oh, what a catch. A
soft liner to the second baseman. He makes the catch, and the inning is over. So the East gets a base hit, but they fail to score. The host is coming up in the bottom of the first. We'll be back in a minute. Okay, folks, we're back. Leadoff batter for the host team is coming to the plate. And number 7, Calvin Chang, the shortstop. Chang's batting 125 in the tournament. And speaking with him today, what he's going to try to do, told me, is try to cut down on his strikeouts. He's struck out 5 times in this tournament. But he's pitched absolutely fantastic, and he's played spectacular defense.
The game he pitched last night was epic.
It sure was.
That was a pitcher's game last night, and you know, Chang is one of the two that made it just so much fun to watch. So let's see if he can get his hitting game back on track here.
Now, and he lines a single
there
over the shortstop's head, and that's a leadoff single for Calvin Chang, just what the doctor ordered for the host District 57 team. I know that makes him feel good. He was really kind of getting down on himself a little bit over those strikeouts last night, so he's put that behind him, and it's going to bring to the plate the pitcher Number 19, Tyler Beach. That was a nice piece of hitting right there, Rick. He just drove that 77-mile-an-hour fastball right over the shortstop's head.
That was a nice hit. A great way to start the game for 57.
Tyler Beach is batting 286 for the tournament. He's had two hits and seven at-bats, both singles, has an RBI, and scored two runs. Squares to bunt and pulls back and takes the ball, 1-0. So Zach Gorman on the mound, power thrower, without question, throws as hard as anybody in this tournament, really. And Chang goes and steals second base. So he got a good jump.
And that was a great throw by Mancusi. Almost got him. And really, that is where I believe this game is going to be won or lost, is from the catcher sitting behind the plate.
Yeah.
Last night we saw the Hawaii team. Tom back there.
Chang's third on the drop ball. He's in there. So the District 57 host team has a runner at third base with nobody out. So they're in business here in the bottom of the first inning.
You know, that's got to make Grant happy and the whole team.
Yeah, this is sort of what Hawaii did to them last night. They got a walk and then a couple of pass balls, and all of a sudden Hawaii had a runner at third base with nobody out and scored. Beach squares to bunt and fouls it off.
And again, both of these teams are defensive powerhouses, so every run is worth its weight in gold here.
Yeah, no question about it. This is not going to be a slugfest. It swung on a miss. Ball gets away. Here comes the runner from third. He's going to score. Safe. And the host team takes a 1-0 lead. The drop third strike.
Beach is going to get first base.
Yep. Beach advances to first. Chang comes in to score from third. And just like that, the host team has taken a 1-0 lead.
Looks like Freehold Township's going to take a couple seconds and talk about it out there. Gathered themselves up a little bit. That's not how they wanted to start this game.
You know, unlike the host team, though, they have a lot of power. And, you know, for them to give up a couple of runs early is not going to be the end of the world. And Tyler Beach
sleeping out there.
Picked off. No? Yes?
Oh, the ball was not in play. So I guess he was.
Aha.
He was afforded some sleep there.
One of those.
It surprised him, though.
One of those deals. Well, he got a second life there, if that's the case, because he was clearly picked off. And that's bringing to the plate the left fielder tonight, Tyler Wood has been primarily used as catcher and pitcher, but tonight he's playing in left field.
Tyler had a bit of a rough outing last night, so I'm wondering if that prompted the move.
Wow, Gorman's got a great move, and he is so close to getting Beach picked off.
Gorman sees something that he likes over there.
Yeah, he's got a big smile on his face. Oh, that was, they do have him picked off.
They got him now.
Throw to second, running him back to first. Back to second again, and he's tagged out. So
that was a rough one. He got a little too far off the base on that one. Nowhere he could go.
So that's the first out of the inning. And now Tyler Wood is batting with nobody on. Good job by Zach Gorman to get Tyler Beach.
And again, talking about deep, perfectly executed pickle play out there by the Yeast.
Yep.
Every run is going to count tonight.
So Tyler Wood's batting 286 for the tournament. He's got two hits and seven at-bats. ...79 miles an hour from Zach Gorman. And, you know, with Zach, it's not just the velocity that is tough. He has a very unique delivery.
Yep.
The ball is hidden extremely well. until the very last second when it comes exploding out from behind him. And at that velocity, it's really tough. Oh, there's an off-speed pitch that was just beautiful. 63 mile an hour. And Tyler Wood goes down swinging. Quite a weapon that East has out there in the mound right now. And that's going to bring to the plate number 16, the first baseman, Noah Garcia. Fouled off. And like most of the post batters last night, Garcia struck out several times.
Although the one thing I can say about Garcia is he has come through in some clutch situations with some very big hits.
Yeah, he's 2-for-9. He's batting .222 for the series. Swing and a miss. Strike three, and that's how the inning ends. Host team comes up with a run. And after one inning, host leads 1-0. Back in a minute.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to start our 50-50 drawing. Our representatives will be passing through the spectator area selling 50-50 drawing tickets. The suggested donation for the ticket is as follows. One ticket, $1. 10 tickets, $5. 25 tickets, $10. Proceeds help fund transportation, food and lodging, and many other necessary costs required to support this wonderful event. Your generosity is appreciated, and one half of the money we collect goes to the lucky winner. The winning ticket will be drawn prior to the end of this game. And the winner must present the winning ticket at our pin booth located behind the seats on the first base dugout side. Leading the top of the second inning for New Jersey. Number 16, fielder John Abrahamson.
So we're back in Livermore. We reached the top of the second inning, and leading off for New Jersey is John Abrahamson. He pops one directly off up to the pitcher, and then one pitch, one out. They've got that powerful Abrahamson out on one pitch.
Hate to borrow a phrase, but this is like deja vu all over again. Yeah. Last night, look at the pitch counts.
Mm-hmm.
Here we are. Low-scoring game, batters being taken care of on first or second pitch, both sides.
That's going to bring to the plate Connor Morey, the first baseman, number 12. Strike on the outside corner. There's a strike. The count is quickly 0-2. Morey's the leading hitter for the East. He's batting .600. He's 3-for-5. He's got a couple of doubles and two RBIs. He's been a great weapon for the East, batting in the six hole generally. Smashes one up the middle. Chang's got it and throws to first for the second out of the inning. And coming to the plate now is Michael Mancusi, the catcher.
I know a lot of people love the slugfest games, but for my money, I love these defensive battles.
Oh, I do too.
To watch these guys execute defensive plays like that with such precision and free of errors, a lot of fun to watch.
But when you get into games like this, the tension is very thick, and every single pitch matters so much that for a fan's perspective, it's really fun to watch. You know, it's hard to get on base, it's hard to advance, it's hard to score. All of those things are what make this game pretty good. Swung on and missed, strike
there
three.
Is.
Tyler Beach makes
beautiful
quick work of the East in the second inning, and after 1.5, the host team leads 1-0.
the low rider. The low rider is a little higher.
In Livermore for the bottom of the second inning, and bottom of the second inning, and leading off for the host team is going to be number 8 center fielder Andrew Gaskell. Gaskell swings and fouls the first pitch off. Gaskell's batting .286 for the tournament. He's 2-for-7. It's fouled off to the right. So that was a pretty impressive bottom of the first inning, Rick, where District 57 was able to manufacture a run. And right there, a swinging dropped third strike that the catcher had plenty of time to pick up and throw to first, but he dropped the ball.
Just got away from him.
Got away from him, and now District 57 has a runner at first base.
All right, third baseman number 6, Cole Osia.
And that's going to bring to the plate the third baseman, Cole Basha. Basha has batted .400 for the series. He's 2-for-5 with 2 singles and 2 RBIs. Ball gets away from the catcher, but not far enough for Gaskell to advance.
Well, again, with a 77-mile-an-hour pitch, that's going to bounce off that wall right back real quick.
So we'll see if Jim Grant sends Gaskell, squares the bunt, and everybody broke in.
Looks like Gaskell's staying pretty close to first base there. I think he learned from the beach incident last inning.
Yeah, I'm sure that...
Because he has a pretty wicked fast throw over to first base.
I'm sure that the message into the dugout from Jim Grant was, we're not getting picked off anymore. We've seen enough of that.
Gorman has been pretty flawless in his pickoff attempts over to first base.
Yeah, he's every bit as good as Beach is over there.
Got a sure-handed Morey on first.
There he goes. Throw down to second base. It's high, and that's going to get away into center field. And that's a stolen base for Andrew Gaskell.
And I do have to say, Gaskell has some wheels on him.
Yeah, you're right. He wasn't getting a huge lead, but he was going to steal that regardless.
Yep.
And so now the host team has a runner at second base, nobody out, and a 3-1 count on Cole Boscia. So they're trying to make some more noise here. Bunt right back to the pitcher. He throws to third base for the tag. He's out at third. What a great play by Gorman. The bunt was just way too hard back to the pitcher. And Gorman had plenty of time to turn and throw to third base, and the tag was applied.
All right, catcher, number 17.
By Anthony Sirico. So that was a tough break for the host team. Boscia reaches, and he's at first base with one out. Ball is lined out of play to the right side. Matthew Abbas is batting 333 for the tournament. He's 2-for-6 with two singles and a couple of RBIs.
Abbas had that key at bat in the game against Texas that sparked their string of runs.
That's right. He just lines one over the shortstop's head for a base hit. And the host team has runners at first and second with one out. The host team is batting only 188 as a team during this tournament. So they've really been struggling to get hits in offense, and they've already got three hits tonight, so it looks like the bats are starting to wake up a little bit for them. And that's going to bring to the plate the center fielder, Ty Clausen. So we'll see how the host team plays this. They put on a bunt play, and it's bunted foul.
And the stats can be a little misleading on this, too, I think, because two of the three teams that they've faced, East and then Hawaii, are defensive powerhouses.
Yeah, tough to manufacture runs against those guys for sure. So, and, you know, great pitchers. So
excellent pitching.
Yeah. So that explains it. Swung on and missed. And Clausen is in an 0-2 hole quickly. Ball misses outside. 76 miles an hour fastball by Zach Gorman. And if anything, what's developing early, Rick, is they're getting Zach Gorman's pitch count up. He's not in any, you know, problem area at this point, but he is starting to work a little bit. Ball inside. Zach's up to 32 pitches in 1 1/3 innings. Oh, that hit him.
Ouch.
That's going to hurt a little. Like Clausen takes a hit batter. Takes a hit batter, and he is now at first base, and the host team has bases loaded with one out. So they're definitely in business here, and that's going to bring to the plate number 9 hitter, second baseman James Murray.
And that just opens up a lot you can do on offense when you have only one out in this situation.
Yeah.
So it'll be interesting to see how they play Murray, who, at least in my memory, has been a solid hitter. You have the exact stats there.
He's only had 4 plate appearances, and he's 1-for-4, batting 250, so...
So I guess I remember his one good hit then.
That's right.
That came in the Texas game.
Sometimes that's all it takes, huh? So the manager went out and had a little chat with... Manager Jeff Gordon had a little chat with his son, Zach. Tried to settle the team down a little bit.
Right.
A little strategy on how to play the defense. The corners are in. Middle infielders are squeezed a bit, but are playing halfway. We might have a special pinch runner. Indeed, we do.
That's there he is. So we got Evan Belingit coming in.
Evan Belingit's going to run at second base as a special pinch runner. So a big moment here for James Murray. Bases are loaded. With one out. Looks like the East is suspecting that we may see a bunt again. Chopped back to the mound. Forced out at home. Throw to first. And they get him.
That's going to end it right there. Oh, that was double, a well-executed play.
That's a double play, and that's how the inning ends. So the East are able to get out of that. And we've played two innings. And the host is leading 1-0. Back in Livermore, we moved to the top of the third inning with the host team leading 1-0. And leading off for Freehold, New Jersey, it's going to be third baseman number 2, Anthony Sirico. Sirico's yet to get a hit in the series. He's over 3. In the tournament, Tyler Beach starts him off with a strike. So that was a rough turn of events for the host team in the last half inning. They had bases loaded, one out, and a dribbler that went back to the pitcher who threw home for the force, and the catcher threw down to first base and recorded the out, and that was a double play and ended the inning. Ball's fouled off to the right. The count is 1-2 to the number 8 hitter for Freehold Township Little League. I want to welcome everybody that's tuned in from the state of New Jersey. Weather's perfect right now. As Sirico strikes out, that's the first out of the inning. That's going to bring to the plate number 9 hitter, Mario Rivera. Mario's looking for his first hit of the tournament. He's 0 for 8. The East, as a collective group, are batting .225 for the tournament. And I know that's well below their standards. Count is 1-1. That's lined down the left field line, foul. And the 1-2 pitch on its way. That's lifted to the first baseman, pop out, and Rivera pops out to first. It's the second out of the inning. It's going to roll the top of the order back over for the East, and that's going to bring Zach Gorman, the pitcher, to the plate.
Now batting the pitcher, number 8, Zach Gorman.
So early on, Rick, it's tough to get runners, it's tough to advance them, and it's doubly tough to score. Ball's popped up, right field. Right fielder coming in, calls everybody off, and there's the third out of the inning.
Gaskell's made some key plays out there in right field this series, and he had to run up to get that one for sure.
And Beach has 34 pitches through three innings. Same with Zach Gorman. We're going to the bottom of the third. The host team leads 1-0. Back in California, folks, for the bottom of the third inning, and the top of the order for the host team comes up. That would be Calvin Chang, the shortstop, who singled and scored in the first inning.
Leading off the bottom of the third inning for Calvin Chang, shortstop number 7, Calvin Chang.
I think we do have a new pitcher for the East.
Looks like Patrick Burns out there on the hill.
All right, Patrick Burns is coming out. Zach Gorman's going to go to shortstop, I'm sure, who just makes the play and retires Calvin Chang. So,
and we have a pitching change for New Jersey. Number 6, Patrick Burns.
So Burns comes in and takes over for Gorman. That's going to bring to the plate a hitter for Tyler Beach, number 10. That's Tyler Aftal is going to come to the plate and bat.
Entering the game and batting. Number 10, Tyler Aftal.
One Tyler comes in and replaces another Tyler.
Too many Tylers on this team.
Way too many.
We have 4 of them on this team.
Yes. On deck is Tyler Wood.
Guess the coach says, Tyler, come here, and half the team drops their stuff. And
That's right. There's a strike, and the count's 1-1.
Curious decision to replace Gorman. He ran into a little trouble loading the bases last inning. But other than that, I really enjoyed watching him pitch.
Yeah, you know, it's not going to surprise me, Rick, if we see him again later on in this game. Oh, that ball's
killed. Oh, my.
If that's fair or foul, fair, gone. Way out of here. That goes over the bleachers.
Aftal.
He absolutely killed it.
Crushed that ball.
That is one of the longest home runs we've had In the 5 years we've been doing this, I can tell you that.
I've been out here all 5 years. I don't think I've seen a home run go that far before. That was an absolute bomb.
Yeah, he just turned on that and just killed it down the line. The only question was going to be whether it was going to stay fair. And it sure did. And that's a home run for the host team. And they've jumped out to a 2-0 lead. Now batting is number 11, Tyler Wood. Quite a substitution there by Jim Grant, wouldn't you say, Rick?
I would say so. He turned on that with authority and just sent it out.
Yeah, that looked like it only cleared the foul pole by about 6 feet fair. So what a shot. And a shot in the arm for the host team that's been struggling for hits and offense. That's a strike, and it counts 2-1 to Tyler Wood, who struck out his first time in the first inning. Chopped foul. It counts even at 2-2. Wood steps out. Strike three on the outside corner. Tyler Wood strikes out for the second time tonight, and that's going to bring you to the plate. Big first baseman, Noah Garcia. So now we have two outs.
All right, first baseman, number 16, Noah Garcia.
You know, Garcia saw Aftal take that one over the fence, and he's not a slouch hitter either.
No. Grounds one into the hole. Gorman's got a long way to go. Picks it up, throws to first. Offline, safe at first base. Very, very tough play by Gorman. He had really no chance. That's an infield single for Noah Garcia. And so he's at first base with two outs.
I was going to say, Garcia's been responsible for some pretty big hits.
Yeah.
Himself, so. This time does just enough to get himself on base.
He's going to bring to the plate Andrew Gaskell. Gaskell reached on a drop third strike that catcher was unable to pick up. Was left stranded during that inning-ending double play in the second inning. There's a good pitch by Patrick Burns. Swung on and missed. And that's how the inning ends.
Perfectly placed on the outside of the plate.
So a big home run for Tyler Aftal has put the host team up 2-0. We're going to move into the top of the fourth inning when we return.
I go get live with the honey. Rolling down the street, I saw this girl when she was pumping. I winked my eyes, got into the ride, went to a club, was jumping. Introduced myself with low, she said, "You're a liar." I said, "I got it going on, baby girl, and I'm on fire." Took her to the hotel, she said, "You're the king." I said, "Be my queen if you know what I mean." Let's do the wild thing.
Back in Livermore, we've reached the top of the fourth inning, and coming up to bat for New Jersey in the top of the fourth is the center fielder, Jace Shapiro. Shapiro hits a hard ground ball to Chang at short, who throws to first, and that's one pitch, one out. And so far for the host team, the script couldn't be any closer to how it was written. Very few pitches by the starting pitcher, Tyler Beach. There's three innings in the books, and he's only thrown 35 pitches, so that's terrific. That ball's popped up out of play. Burns singled his first time up. Was stranded at first base.
Well, once again, just like the other games, the defense is just out there doing their job.
Ball's hit to third base. Long Basha. Throw to first. Got him. Nice play there.
Basha on that one, but everybody's contributing from Aftal, Garcia, Chang with that last play.
Yep. That's going to bring to the plate number 18, Jonathan Olick.
So District 57 just playing to their strength.
Olick's got the highest batting average for the team on the tournament. He's 4-for-10 with two singles and two doubles, and he scored three runs. Ball's hammered to left field. That's going to get by the left fielder all the way to the wall. And Olick's going to cruise into second base with a double. Nice piece of hitting there.
That was a well-hit ball.
And with two outs, that's going to bring to the plate John Abrahamson.
All right, number 68, John Abrahamson.
Abrahamson is batting 375 in this series with two home runs, four RBIs.
And they have their first runner in scoring position. So good time for Abrahamson to come to the plate.
Yeah, indeed it is. That's exactly what the East was looking for, to get some runners ahead of some of the power that's coming up. And Abrahamson possesses the most power on the team without question. Ron Frisch is going to go out to the mound and talk to his pitcher, hopefully to try to get this final out and get back in the dugout. There's two outs in this inning. So just a quick chat by Ron Frisch. He is accustomed to doing that quite often. And Tyler Beach is going to stand back on the mound and look in at John Abrahamson. And he has a count of 0-1 against him. Olick's being held at second base by James Murray. So there's a pretty big hole on the right side of the infield. Defense is fairly deep and straight away. Ball's lined foul to the right side. And the count is now 0-2 to the dangerous John Abrahamson. So Beach has to bear down here and muster up some of his best efforts to put an end to this East rally. Abrahamson's got other ideas on that, however. And the 0-2 pitch on its way. Ball outside, that just missed. It was a good pitch.
See if he goes back to that outside corner again.
Well, that's been his out location for sure. But
it has been. And he got Sirico to bite on it last inning for a strikeout.
Abrahamson's covers the outside of the plate really well, though. It's going to have to be a pretty good pitch. There it is, and it's fouled off. That's exactly what he did. He went down to that outside corner, 66 miles an hour. Beach is not a terribly hard thrower, but what he does well is he locates
his fastball on both the inside and outside part of the plate and rarely misses down the middle. So now he looks in for his 1-2 pitch, and here it comes. That was inside. Runner goes to third and steals it easily. So Olick's at now at third base with two outs, where he could score on any type of pass ball or error. And at this level, that happens quite a bit, so it's always a good move to get your guy down to third base. Beach comes in for the 1-2. It's popped up. Shallow center field. Center fielder's coming in. Chang's going out, and Chang's got it. That was a huge out there for
Chang just takes care of it, digs him out of that, and keeps the shutout going for District 57.
We played 3.5 innings out here in California. The host team leads the East 2-0. Back at Max Baer Park, we've reached the bottom of the fourth inning, and leading off for the host team is going to be the third baseman, number 6, Cole Basha. Basha reached on a fielder's choice his last at bat. He takes the first ball, misses for a ball, and it's 1-0. There's a strike at the outside corner from Pat Burns at 71 miles an hour, and the count is even at 1. Hammered into left field for a base hit. That was really stroked well. Got to be impressed a little bit with the way the host team, Rick, has come back from that really, really tough game they had against Hawaii, where I think they struck out 15 times in that game. I mean, they couldn't even make contact. Completely different looking team tonight.
Completely different. But then again, they're not facing Andrew Painter either.
Keone Painter.
Power.
No, there's no doubt about that. But these guys are no slouches in their own right.
Not at
That's
all.
Fouled off at the plate. The East has some really, really good power arms. The count is 0-1. It's Matthew Abbas. Ball misses, throw back to first base, and a good throw might probably get him. He short hopped it though, and was first baseman had to come off the bag to corral it. So
they dodge another bullet on that
yeah,
one.
Yeah, so Basha was able to scamper back. And Abbas has a 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. He squares the bunt again and misses, and that's going to be. He offered at that, so the count is now 1-2. Let's see if Bosch is on the move anytime soon. Foul, hit deep to right field. I'm not sure if that's going to stay fair. Yes, it does. Right fielder made a catch in foul territory. Very, very good play by the right fielder.
That's Olick out there. And that was an excellent play, getting on his horse and getting out there out into foul territory to grab that one.
Nice, yeah, nicely done. He's going to bring to the plate. Looks like we might have another. Is this Blake Alameda coming to the plate? Number 18?
Yep, that does look like Blake Alameda right there.
So
he's going to come in and...
Blake Alameda is going to get his first plate appearance today. He's going to bat for Ty Clausen in the number 8 hole.
Number 18, Blake Alameda.
So Alameda up in a position to where he can move Basha over if Basha doesn't try to move over on his own via stolen base. Patrick Burns also has a pretty quick move over to first. Stands on the very right corner of the pitching mound. Here's the pitch. Strike down the middle. Alameda's taking, and the count is 0-1. Well, looking forward to seeing who ends up advancing. Basha goes, throw down to second base, hits the runner, squirts away in the center field, but not far enough for a further advancement. But it's going to be interesting to see who ends up in these championship games. We already know that the international championship will take place Saturday at 1 o'clock here, and it's going to match up the team from the Latin American champions from Venezuela against the Puerto Rican champions from Guayama, Puerto Rico, and that's going to be a rematch. That's going to be a terrific game.
Those are two exciting teams to watch right there as well.
High chopper gets over the third baseman's head. Here comes the run. He's going to try to score. Here comes the throw. He stands up and scores. Runner goes down to second base. Nice piece of hitting there from Blake Alameda, who hits a high chopper that went right over the third baseman's head. Great job by Basha to get down to second base on the stolen base, and everything seems to be working early for the host team, and they go out to a 3-0 lead. That was just good piece of hitting, very fortunate.
Just got the right bounce on that one.
Third baseman was jumped as high as he could, and he missed it by 6 inches. It just went into left field, and Basha, who had stolen second base the previous pitch, was able to come in to score. And now we're going to see Zach Gorman back again. What was I saying, Rick?
There you have it.
It wasn't going to surprise me too much if you saw that occur, because I just felt that was a pitching change to just kind of give him a little bit of a break for some reason. But he's back in there. And Burns goes back to shortstop.
And they've got Ty Clausen in to run the bases.
Okay,
for
special
Alameda.
Special pinch runner. Alameda does his job.
Gets the hit.
And the ribby.
And we get to see Chris White for the first time tonight as well.
Very good. So Chris White's going to come in and hit for James Murray. So District 57 now has a runner at second base with one out, and they've scored one run already in this inning and lead 3-0. White, I wouldn't be shocked if he wasn't bunting, and he does. Lays a beautiful bunt down. It just rolls foul. Jim Grant loves to bunt. He'll bunt at any time, in any count, any situation, if he feels like he wants to put pressure on the defense. Gorman comes in with a breaking ball. White offers at it and goes behind 0-2. Swing swung on a miss, strike three, and White goes down. And that's going to bring to the plate the leadoff hitter for the host team, number seven shortstop, Calvin Chang.
All right, number seven, Calvin Chang.
Yeah, Chang got off the schneid with his first at bat tonight, and I'm sure he'd love nothing more than an RBI to add to his totals tonight.
Yeah, he started this this night for the host team with a solid single, very first plate appearance, and ended up scoring in the first inning. He grounded out to third in the second inning, so he's one for two. Gorman looks in with an 0-1 count now. Misses outside, and the count's even at 1-1. Now, what a beautiful night tonight. I mean, you couldn't have asked for any better weather. God, it's just beautiful.
These evening games have just been magical. Yeah. The weather, perfect.
We've had quite a bit of cloud cover here today, so it kept the temperature down, and it's very comfortable right now. Not sure what the temp is. Ah, there it is, 84 degrees. Yeah, you can't ask for anything better than that. Humidity 33%. Lights are on here at Max Baer as evening sets in California. There's a strike. Strike three. That's the final out of the inning. Chang goes down looking. But the host team scores another run in the bottom of the fourth inning and takes a 3-0 lead. We'll be back with the fifth inning after this. We've reached the top of the fifth inning. Host team leads 3-0, and we're going to have a pinch hitter for the East. It's going to be Connor Quinn, number 10, coming into bat.
Connor Quinn.
A little bit of a delay here. Umpire's checking. Perhaps pitch count. So just a reminder, we will not be doing live stream. This is our last game, in fact, doing live stream. Saturday, the International Championship game will take place at 1 o'clock Pacific time. The United States Championship will occur at 5 p.m. Both of those games will be broadcast via ESPN on ESPN3 only. The Sunday final, I believe it's at 6 p.m. West Coast time, and that will be televised on ESPN2. And that will match up the winners of the two Saturday games. Again, the first game, International Championship game will be the Latin American champions from Venezuela versus Puerto Rico. And the United States Championship game as the West champions from Maui, Hawaii, facing off against the winner of this game. We have some sort of a conference that's going to be going on, so I'm going to put the headphones down for a minute. Get back in a second.
Thank you.
All right, after a lot of talking, I guess we finally get to see what Connor Quinn's up to here.
So just to clarify what the issue was when Zach Gorman came back in and pitched last inning for the second time, there was some confusion as to how many pitches his total pitch count now is. And so that was clarified as 41 total pitches Gorman now has. In Little League Baseball, obviously at this level, you can pitch. You can be removed one time. As long as you don't leave the game, you just simply go to another position, you can come back and pitch later in the game. And that's what happened. Gorman was the starting pitcher. Pitched two innings plus. Patrick Burns came in and pitched. And then Gorman came back in. Ground ball to third base. Long throw. Got him. Good play.
That was a great throw by Bosch, and Garcia over on first, sure-handed as ever.
And that's the first out of the top of the fifth inning. And that's going to bring to the plate number 14, Brad Salamone. Salamone is going to hit for Mancusi. That ball's fouled off to the left.
That was a strong hit.
Just foul. Got in front of it. So the nice quick pace we had to this game, Rick, has suddenly slowed down to a bit of a crawl.
That's okay. We'll get the mojo back, I'm sure.
Long delays.
The way these guys are playing.
Right. Hopefully the actual play on the field hasn't been affected by a couple of delays we've had. And the count is 1-1. Ball's reached for and served out to left field for a base hit. Good piece of hitting by Brad Salamone. He went outside the strike zone on that off-speed pitch and just pulled it into left field for a hit. And so
I get the feeling Salamone knew exactly where he was going with that.
Yeah, it looked like he knew exactly what was coming.
It looks like that's going to do it for Tyler Beach tonight.
So Tyler Beach walks off to a big round of applause by the big local fan base here. Gave everything that Grant wanted him to give. And we're going to see a new pitcher. And who's that going to be, Rick? Looks like Blake Alameda is going to come in and pitch.
Say, that's Alameda.
We'll come back in a minute after he's done with his warm-ups. The East has runner at first base, one out, in the top of the fifth inning, trailing 3-0.
Now pitching for District 57, number 18, Blake Alameda.
Okay, so we're back. Blake Alameda is now on the mound for the host team.
Number five, J.J. Donahue.
And J.J. Donahue is going to get his first plate appearance. He's going to bat for Anthony Sirico. It's a breaking ball that comes in for a strike, and the count is 0-1. Let's go, Alameda's pitched three and two-thirds innings in this World Series. He's given up one run and four hits, struck out five, so he's capable of striking out some batters here. Ball misses. Another off-speed pitch. And so we'll see if Salamone is in the mood to try to steal a base here. The count 1-1. Ball's hammered. Ball down the left field line. That's going to get Salamone over to third base. Nope, he holds up at second. So the East has runner. East have runners at first and second now with one out.
Belinget hustled out to that out in left field and saved a base there.
Mario Rivera is going to come to the plate with an RBI opportunity. Looks like we get a special pinch runner. Connor Morey?
That is Connor Morey.
Connor Morey is going to take over the base running at first base. So a big moment for Mario with runners at first and second with one out. And time is called, and catcher's going to go out and talk to Blake Alameda. If Rivera can reach here in any form or fashion, it's going to set up the East with a potentially big inning as the top of the order will come up and their slew of dangerous hitters will be coming up with runners on base. It hit to short, caught. Oh, what a great play by Chang. Throws for the force play at third base. That was terrific. That saved a run.
Some heads up play by Chang and some fantastic execution. Reaching for that one and then getting it over to third just in time to get the out.
So that's a second out of the inning.
And that takes a little bit of the weight off the shoulders. Nine. Certainly not out of danger yet.
Yeah, that brings to the plate Zach Gorman, the leadoff hitter. And now there's two outs with runners at first and second. Rivera hit it hard, but into the hole, and Chang was able to backhand it. Got a nice clean hop, backhand it nicely, and threw over to third base for the force. The ball on the outside corner, it misses. Breaking ball. 55 miles an hour, so Blake Alameda is featuring at this point nothing but off-speed pitches. Big moment in this game, Rick. This is an opportunity for the East to chip into this 3-0 deficit. That ball is a strike on the outside corner, another floating 54 mile an hour.
No, this is the opportunity the East has been looking for to get back into this game. And they definitely have it set up, and let's see if District 57 shutdown defense holds.
And the 1-1 pitch, fastball, strike, 65 miles an hour. So Blake Alameda is featuring a array of different speeds at these East hitters, and he's got them a little off balance at this point. And now he's got a 1-2 count in his favor with two outs and runners at first and second. That ball's hit into the hole on the right side, through into the right field. Right fielder's coming up, and they're not going to send the runner. But the bases are now loaded with two outs. That's a smart play by Jeff Gorman at third base to especially with some of the power he's got coming up, to not take a chance and have a runner thrown out at the plate to end the inning.
Well, again, every run is gold tonight.
So a nice piece of hitting by Zach. He went to the opposite field on that and smoked it through the right side.
And it shows the confidence he's got in Shapiro here.
Now Shapiro's, you know, he's homered in this tournament, so he does have power. It's his only hit of the tournament so far. So there's two outs. Ball misses outside. The count's 1-0. Shapiro steps out and gathers his thoughts, takes a deep breath, and steps back in.
That's a lot of pressure on this young man's shoulders, too.
Yep, that sure is.
Step up into this kind of situation.
Let's see what he's got in him. See what kind of moxie he's got. Ball's right back up the middle, and Alameda spears it.
Oh, my.
That ball was on a line. Went right back to Alameda. All he could do was just cover his face with the glove. Catches the ball, and that's how the inning ends. So the East leaves the bases loaded. They got a real bad break right there. That was probably going to score two runs. And we've played 4.5 innings in California. The host team leads 3-0.
Back in Livermore,
Tyler Aftal.
And up to the plate, Tyler Aftal, whose last hit, if you remember, was way over the fence.
That's correct. Big home run hitter's up. That was definitely the move of the night for Jim Grant. Slowly hits a shortstop, throw to first. Safe at first,
but
beats it out. Great hustle by Aftal.
He turned on the afterburners the last 10 feet of that.
The ball was slowly lined to the shortstop. As soon as it hit the, it must have had a ton of top spin.
Looked like it had some spin on that.
Because as soon as it hit the ground, it just almost stopped.
And it kicked up some dirt, too.
Yeah,
so
and that slowed it down enough for Aftal to be able to reach.
Looks like we might have a little conference about this one as well.
Not quite sure what they could be talking about. I doubt that the home plate umpire is going to overrule. They call that the first base umpire has not only a better view of, but he's 10 feet away. So So anyways, there's a base hit for an infield hit for Afdahl. Host team has leadoff man on in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Tell you what, Afdahl making the case for MVP tonight.
Absolutely. Except he almost got himself picked off. It's amazing how many runners the host team have had picked off or very close to it, isn't it, Rick?
It is, and you didn't see it a lot while Burns was on the mound, but Gorman has an arm.
Yeah, he's got a great move. I mean, you just have to...
Dangerous. You have to respect that.
You got to respect it. You just can't get picked off. So Tyler Wood steps up. He struck out once looking and once swinging. Other throw. Oh, it's getting close over there. Afdahl needs to take about half the lead he's been taking. But, you know, there he goes. He's going to steal. Oh, it got the umpire. Ball was not caught by the catcher. And it hit the umpire directly in the shoulder. Okay, I think. So Afdahl steals. He's at second base now with nobody out. And Tyler Wood has an RBI opportunity now. So in the bottom of the fifth inning, the host team has done no wrong so far in this game, and they lead 3-0. And they're threatening again here in the fifth. And any run that they can tack on late in this game like it is, Rick, is going to just be huge. Against this East team, you can't score enough runs.
Most definitely. I mean, we saw last inning when the East loaded up the bases, threatened that three-run lead.
Yeah, that was...
District 57 caught a break with that hit right back to the pitcher.
Yeah, they sure did. So Tyler Wood has offered it a couple of fastballs at bunt attempts, and he's got the count at 2-2 to him. So he'll be swinging away right here, I would imagine. And he hits it off the end of the bat towards the right side. Pitcher collects it, tosses underhand. And a productive out for Mr. Tyler Wood as he advances the runner to third, and that's where Afdahl is with one out. Anytime you can make an out, Rick, and have it be a productive out like that, you're going to get some attaboys when you get in the dugout. That's going to bring to the plate Noah Garcia. Garcia has struck out and singled.
I think Garcia is still hungry to get a hold of one.
I think you're right. So there's a strike on the outside corner. Now the East has brought the infield in. They realize that they are not in a position to be able to give up too many more runs here. Of course, when you do that, you open up the possibility of a big inning. Oh, that ball gets away. Afdahl thinks about it, but decides to hold. I would suggest that Tyler Afdahl, unless it's absolutely 100% he's going to make it, that he gives Noah Garcia a chance with the infield in to hit the ball. Hate to see that runner get thrown out trying to steal. Ball's chopped at the plate and fouled, and the count is 1-2. Here comes 1-2. That ball's lifted to left field. That's going to get the run home. Caught, tagging, strong throw to the plate, safe at the plate. And Noah Garcia does a job. It's a sack fly to left field. And the host team has gone up 4-0. Good piece of hitting with two strikes, Rick, for Noah Garcia.
Definitely, and it is almost impossible to understate how important that fourth run is. That is huge for the host team.
And that's going to bring to the plate Andrew Gaskell. Gaskell has struck out. He struck out twice, actually, in this game. He's now up with two outs and nobody on base.
Number eight, Andrew Gaskell.
appeal at third to see if Aftal had left too early.
Well, I was watching him. I think he almost left too late.
I was going to say the same thing.
They played it very safe over there.
Yeah, there was no question about that. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
He left late enough that I was starting to worry whether he was actually going to make it home.
Right. That was a strong throw by the left fielder.
That was a big throw.
Hit the right field directly on the line, and that's how the inning ends.
Right there. Olick right under it.
Yeah, good job there. So the inning ends. We played five innings in Livermore, California, and the host team leads. Four to nothing. Back in a minute.
$216. It is a white ticket. 027-439. 027-439. $216. Take your ticket down to the pin booth and right tail line and present your ticket to you.
Back at Livermore, the number three batter for the East Regional Champs is going to lead off this inning, and that's going to be Patrick Burns. Burns has singled, and he has singled again. Singled.
Do it again.
Nice job, Pat. It's two hits for him. And the leadoff man is on in the sixth inning for New Jersey, trailing 4-0. That's going to bring to the plate Jonathan Olick.
It's going to bring the power twins up. Olick and following that up with Abrahamson. So
yeah,
it's
good
to have a base runner in position here.
Yeah, this is
looks like Frisch is going to take a little time and
it's a big moment here
and chat about this one with the infield.
Be back in a minute. Okay, we're back at Max Baer Park. Jonathan Olick steps up. Olick has popped out to the second baseman and doubled. The East has a runner at first base and Patrick Burns, who singled to open the inning. The strike on the outside corner. The count is 0-1. So here is the key to the game with the host team having to go through this part of the lineup in the sixth inning. And this is the East's best chance of the night so far to put some runs on the board. Ball misses.
And this is the opportunity for the East get it right through the heart of the lineup here, because if this passes, it's going to be hard to see this section of the lineup again in this game.
Yeah, there won't be much time. So that's a strike. Good pitch on the inside corner by Alameda, and the count is 2-2. Alameda's featured a lot of different off-speed pitches. Let's see what he's got here. First, he checks over at Burns at first base. Burns down by four runs. Doesn't appear to be thinking about stealing. Here comes the 2-2. Now to Olick. Ball's popped up foul out of play. And they'll do the 2-2 count again. We got big fans on, groups of fans on both sides. Obviously, the host team is going to have the majority of them, but quite a few East fans as well on the right side of us. They're waiting to get loud as well here. So the 2-2 offering to Olick on its way. First is checked over to second. To first base. Fouled off again. Remains 2-2. Well, you can cut the tension with a knife out here, Rick, right now. This is, everybody's on pins and needles. I know I am.
Definitely. And Olick fighting that one off. Looking to see what Alameda will deliver next.
Fouled off to the right. And the count remains 2-2. Ball's hit hard to third. They go to second for one. Back to first. Safe. So they get an out at second base, but Olick reaches on a fielder's choice, and that's going to bring to the plate John Abrahamson. Abrahamson popped to the pitcher and lined to the shortstop.
Number 16,
his
John
second time
Abrahamson.
Up. So he's looking to get unleashed in this game, Rick. He's got to be an imposing figure for any pitcher up there. He's got a great stance. He's has an open stance. Big kid. He hits one down the line. That's going to be foul. Had the distance. That was going to be a home run, I think, Norm, right? Okay, nope. It was going to be off the fence, but it's a foul ball. And that's just a loud strike is what that amounts to.
Well, you're right. I mean, having these two power hitters up, District 57 with a small victory getting the lead runner there, but that certainly doesn't end the threat. Abrahamson, like you said, imposing at the plate.
Yeah, and Morey's a good hitter too. So grounded to Chang at second, throw to first, safe at first. But again, if another fielder's choice, a force out at second base. Good call by the umpire at first base. He had beat it. And so Connor Morey, the first baseman, is going to come up with now two outs and a runner at first base. So great defense by the host team.
All right. Number 12, Connor Morey.
Chang at short especially has just played a terrific game.
He has. He's come through in the clutch several times tonight.
And everything that's hit at him has been fielded cleanly. And with two outs, the host team is looking to put away Morey and get back in the dugout going into the bottom of the sixth inning, leading 4-0. Ball gets away and the runner advances down to second base. Throw down. but Abrahamson moves well. Big man. I shouldn't say man, big kid. He's just got the size of a man.
Yeah.
I guess that's what I'm trying to get at. So the count is 2-0 to Connor Morey. Swing and a miss on an outside corner pitch, and the count is 2-1. Good pitch by Alameda. Come back on a nice strike when he's down 2-0. Abrahamson's getting a pretty good lead. Second baseman Murray is holding him on. That ball's hit directly to Murray. Easy routine play for the second baseman. And host team shuts down the threat. No runs. One hit by the East. And we've played six complete innings in California, and the host team leads the East 4-0. We've reached the bottom of the sixth inning out here in California. And leading off for District 57 is Cole Basha. Basha's hit into a fielder's choice, singled and scored in the fourth inning.
Basha's had a fantastic game tonight. Not only just getting that hit there and in the last at bat, but also a lot of good work over at third base tonight.
Yeah, no doubt.
A couple of really tough throws cross field that he's made that have kept the East off the board.
So Gorman still in for his fifth inning of work. He's up to 56 pitches now. And Jeff Gorman's going to ride him out for the remainder of this game. It appears. Count is 1-2 to Cole Basha. Swung on and missed. And that's strike three.
Gorman's firing now with a little bit of fire. You can see that in his eyes.
I want to put out a special thanks to Clay Wood, head groundskeeper for the Oakland A's, who's been out here on a couple of occasions and helped us with this field. Field always looks fantastic during the World Series, and it takes an enormous amount of work. Our head groundskeeper out here, Bill Abumarad, puts in hundreds and hundreds of man hours to keep this, get this field not only to where it's supposed to be before the tournament, but to keep it looking like this during the tournament. So big thanks to you, Bill. Bill also cooked our tacos tonight, so this guy does everything.
I have to go stop by the tent tonight. A man of many talents, I didn't know that.
Many talents.
The grounds do look absolutely fantastic, though.
It's not easy. This heat this week's been exceptionally warm, which makes it even obviously tougher. Matthew Abbas is now down in the count. Excuse me, it's 1-1. Swung on and missed. That's it. Strike three. Count was wrong. Game changer. And that's a second strikeout, so Zach Gorman's settling in. That's going to bring to the plate number two. Ty Clausen's going to come back and get another at-bat. He was hit by a pitch in the second inning in his only plate appearance. Okay, we're back.
Gorman is just pitching with a special kind of fire right now.
Yeah, he's bringing it pretty good.
He is exciting to watch.
Swung on and missed. Also want to thank a couple of guys up here that are responsible for not only all of the sound that you hear makes me sound a lot better than I actually am. That's Jeff Martin and also Dave McDonald. Involved in the camera work, the sound systems. They do a heck of a job. So that's a strike. Gorman strikes out the side. And we're going to go into the top of the seventh inning. New Jersey's looking at their last at-bats here. And they've got to pick up 4 runs to send this game, to keep this game going. We'll be back in a minute.
Last chance Texaco here for East.
Brad Salamone is going to be leading off the top of the seventh inning for the East. He swings and misses at the first pitch.
They haven't quite figured out Alameda yet.
Yeah, he's been just a different...
not your traditional pitcher, but he's getting the job done.
Different look than Beach for sure. It's another swing and a miss. Salamone had a great, nice base hit his last time up, his only plate appearance back in the fifth inning. Now he's down in the count 0-2. I also want to thank everybody that helped me do this live stream this year. Acted as a color. That would be my partner to my left right now, Rick Rude.
You're welcome. It's been a blast.
Ed Hugo, who's out there, I know, watching somewhere. And Mark Spiller. Had a blast doing that with all you guys. And I know everybody had a good time doing it. Nobody's ever done this before. So, you know, you get the best seat in the house and you get to talk a little bit. So
totally.
It's a great job.
It's baseball. How can you go wrong, right?
That's right. Ball's lifted to the second baseman, an easy pop-up, and that's one out in the seventh inning. New Jersey's down to their last two outs. That's going to bring to the plate. Can't catch a number here yet.
Looks like that's number five. That's J.J. Donahue.
J.J. Donahue's, yep. He's re-entering. He's already batted once tonight.
Re-entering the game and batting. Number five, J.J. Donahue.
So J.J. Donahue in the eighth hole. It's another at bat. I believe he singled in the fifth inning. And was stranded at second base. He was stranded at second base when that line shot occurred, and that's been the East's best chance to get something on the board up to this point. And now they're down to their last two outs. So the job for Donahue is to get on. The job for Rivera following him would be to get on and get that meat of the lineup for the East back up for one more chance at the host team. So the count's 1-1. Grounded to Chang at short. Picks it up. Throws across the diamond. And that's the second out.
And right now, the host District 57 team, one out away from making history, being the first host team to get to the finals.
Absolutely.
And you know they want another shot at Hawaii.
That's true. That's true. That would be a great rematch if it was to occur, and we're one out away from that happening.
Well, I'll tell you what. Talk about great games. Every game that I've been to out here this year has been a fantastic game.
Yeah, there hasn't been a bad one yet.
At this level of play, it's just exciting to watch.
Line drive, base hit by Rivera, so he does his job. Smokes a ball to left field. And that's going to bring to the plate Zach Gorman. So the East is not going to go quietly here. And you would never expect them to. They're a very proud team. And they're going to go down to the last batter. But Zach Gorman's going to try to extend this inning. Gorman has struck out, flied out to right field, and singled in his three plate appearances. And this game started with, on offense, a solid single by Chang. The host team was able to put a run on the board in the very first inning and set the tone. Tyler Beach came in as a pitcher and shut down the East team. And it's just continued on that way throughout the whole game. And except for that one inning where the East loaded the bases and then lined out to the pitcher, they really haven't been able to muster too much offense tonight. And I think you have to give credit to the host team. I mean, they've really, up to this point, made every play in the field. They aren't walking anybody. I mean, I'm not even sure if there's been a base on balls in this game. There hasn't. So they haven't walked a batter, nope. And they haven't made an error. And I know that Jim Grant preaches that constantly. And when they're able to perform like that, they can play with anybody. And that was proven tonight.
And I know it's a football saying, but I think it applies equally as much to baseball. Defense wins championships.
Yep. With the added element of pitching. The count is now 2-2. There's two outs. Zach Gorman waits the 2-2 pitch, fouls it off. Just got a piece of it. And the New Jersey team is down to their final strike. Alameda looks in. And here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hit to Chang at short. He backhands it, throws to second base, into right field. Safe. It looks like Rivera at second base has injured. He's keeled over. Hopefully he's okay. Chang went deep in the hole, backhanded the ball, threw to second base, but by the time he threw there, the second baseman and the runner were arriving at the same time, and there was a collision. He looks like he's okay. Atta boy, Mario. Tough kid. What a great personality, too. So he's fine. Just maybe got the wind knocked out of him for a little bit. But on the play, the East remains alive, and they now have runners at first and second with two outs. That's going to be an infield hit for Gorman, his second hit of the game. And it's going to bring to the plate Jace Shapiro, the right fielder.
Number 13, Jace Shapiro.
So this is the batter that the host team wants to end the game on, and they don't want any part of Burns, Olick, or Abrahamson. And all three of those guys are looming. There's a floater, breaking ball for a strike, 53 miles an hour. That Shapiro takes for a strike. The count is 0-1. Ball's hit down the right field line. It's going to be foul. And wow, what a great effort by the right fielder, but it just fell.
Gaskell can't quite get there.
Yep.
Just ran out of real estate on that one.
And once again, the East Regional Champions from Freehold Township Little League in Freehold, New Jersey are down to their last strike. So Alameda is ahead 0-2 to Shapiro. And he wants to go through the signs again. Imagine what's going through his mind right now, Rick.
So much right now on both of these.
Line, base hit to center field. That's going to score a run. Nope, they're going to hold up Rivera. Throw comes in. Wisely held him up. That was a great throw back.
Huge throw from Clausen out there in center field.
I thought that was going to be an easy run scored. So the East has the tying run now coming to the plate in the form of Patrick Burns. That's three consecutive singles now for the East. Catcher goes out and has a word with Alameda. So the East Regional champs are a big fly away from tying this game. Burns has singled twice in this game and grounded out to the third baseman. And this is the second time tonight that the East has had the bases loaded with two outs. First pitch is high, and the count is 1-0. So there's a lot of nervousness in this ballpark right now.
Thought the tension was thick before.
Yep. Right. That ball is hit out. It's way out of here. That is a game-tying grand slam by Patrick Burns. Holy Toledo.
A amazing hit.
What a comeback. They were down to their final strike on two separate occasions in this game. And Patrick Burns just hit a long grand slam. Amazing turn of events here in California. You ever seen a game like this, Rick, in a while?
This is amazing.
I love it.
They loaded the bases up last inning and got the lucky line drive right back at the pitcher. This time they load the bases and they are able to tie it up with a well-placed grand slam.
So Jim Grant is going to come over, make a pitching change, it looks like.
Like he's going to put in Matthew Abbas here.
Matthew Abbas is going to come in. We're going to take a little break here as he warms up. We all gather our emotions and our thoughts, and we'll be back in a minute.
Now pitching for District 57, number 17, Matthew Abbas.
So we are back in Livermore, California at Max Baer after witnessing one of the greatest comebacks you'll ever see in a Little League game, or a game at any level, to be honest with you. The East were down to their last strike on two separate occasions, and Patrick Burns hit a game-tying grand slam, or tied at four. There's two outs and nobody on base. John Abrahamson is up, and the count is 0-2 now, and he swings like he was trying to duplicate the ball that Burns just hit.
Well, and you saw in New Jersey. New Jersey just, they played it cool. They didn't panic. They came out. They knew the situation. They knew it was two outs, and they just chipped away, loaded the bases.
And it all started with a single by Mario Rivera with two outs and nobody on. Number nine hitter. This is Jonathan Olick, by the way. I'm sorry. I said it was John Abrahamson. It's Jonathan Olick at the plate now with a count of 1-2. So Salamone started the inning off by hitting a pop-up to the second baseman. J.J. Donahue grounded out to the shortstop. So there was two outs and nobody on. Mario Rivera singled. Zach Gorman singled. Jay Shapiro singled. And Burns hit a grand slam. What an incredible turn of events. Game is obviously not over. The host team still has an opportunity to win it in the bottom of the seventh.
Olick's climbed back into this one.
Ball is lined into right field, and that's a base hit for Jonathan Olick, and that's going to bring to the plate Jonathan Abrahamson, and the East has put together 5 consecutive hits. Abrahamson's coming up to the plate now with a runner at first base and two outs. And there hasn't been a cheap hit in this entire inning. Everything has been smoked. So this host crowd is absolutely stunned, and they're silent right now. But they realize that their boys still have a chance in the bottom of the seventh. Abrahamson takes the first pitch for a strike, fastball. The 0-1. Grounded back up the middle. Chang's got it. Steps on the bag, and that's how the inning ends. However, the East comes back with four runs on five hits. No errors and one run left on. The highlight, a Patrick Burns grand slam. We're going to the bottom of the seventh, tied up at four. We're back here in Livermore for the bottom of the seventh inning. The host team is going to try to regroup and see if they can push across the winning run in the bottom of the seventh inning. It's going to have to start with number nine hitter, James Murray.
So I'm just left with two thoughts. I mean, number one, how big was that run that District 57 got in the fifth inning?
Right.
And number two, how sad is ESPN that they're getting here a day late, because that was the play of the series.
Exactly.
Right there. That was unbelievable.
Yeah, there's no question about it, as Murray grounds out to the shortstop, and that's how the inning starts. There's one out in the top of the order is now coming up, and Calvin Chang. Chang has singled, grounded out to shortstop, and struck out looking.
All right, number seven, Calvin Chang.
Gorman pours in a 78-mile-an-hour fastball, misses outside. It's a pitch on the outside corner for a strike, and the count's 1-1. Alvin Chang goes after a high heater, and he's down in the count 1-2, and Gorman has new life, obviously, in this game. Obviously, that East team is fired up right now. Swung on and missed, strike three. And now there's two outs.
Gorman is pitching like he is possessed.
That's going to bring Tyler Aftal to the plate. Aftal's homered in this game.
The laser-like focus and the sharp, crisp delivery.
Aftal. He's bringing it, too. Aftal takes the first pitch down the middle for a strike. Golf fouls it off, and he's behind in the count quickly at 0-2. Ball outside, count 1-2. Yeah. Strike three called, and that's how the inning ends. So host team fails to score in the bottom of the seventh inning. And we're going extra innings here, folks, and we wouldn't want to have it any other way. Tied 4-4 going into the eighth. We're going extra innings here in California at Max Baer Park. Hope everybody's still with us out there in live stream land. Connor Morey is going to lead off for the East. Morey has grounded out to the shortstop, the third baseman, and the second baseman in this game, so he's 0-3. And it's going to be, Rick, really interesting to see how this game ends up after those turn of events in the last inning.
The momentum has shifted a little bit.
If you believe in that, I would agree. You know, a lot of people
don't. However, you know, anything can still happen. I mean, with the tie game, top of the eighth, it's like a brand new game.
That's right. Swung on and missed. Morey goes down swinging in the eighth inning. That's how the inning starts, and that's going to bring to the plate Brad Salamone. Salamone has singled and popped out to second base in this game. Grounded to second base. Routine. Throws him out. A little bit of a bobble at second base. Took a strange hop. But he recovered and threw him out. And that's a second out of the inning. And that is going to bring to the plate J.J. Donahue. Donahue grounded out. Singled and grounded out in this game as well. And this would be a big boost for the host team to if they could retire this batter and start the next inning, if there is one, with the number nine hitter leading off.
And again, at least out on the infield, it looks like District 57 is shaking off whatever jujus they had with what happened in the last inning.
That's
and
for sure.
They're back to making quality plays out on the diamond.
Yeah, and Abbas has come back nicely as well. He wasn't the pitcher that gave up the grand slam. However, he came in and shut the door down. He's thrown pretty hard, 76 miles an hour. The count is 3-1, however, to J.J. Donahue now. That's fouled off, and the count is now full. So Abbas looks in, throws. That's the first walk of the ball game for the host team, pitching staff, and it's going to bring to the plate the igniter from last inning, Mario Rivera. If you remember, there were two outs and nobody on in the top of the seventh inning, and Mario Rivera stepped up, representing the last chance for the East, and he hit a hard single to left field, and that it just absolutely ignited the East offense. Now he's batting in the top of the eighth with a runner at first base and two outs. Oh, great pitch by Abbas there. Great off speed, 63 mile an hour curveball that floats in for a strike. And the count is 0-1. That ball was over the head of Rivera. He ducked down and avoided getting hit. Fouled off, and the count's 1-2.
You know that Abbas wants to shut it down right here because he does not want to take a look at the next three batters coming up.
Well, especially with anybody on base. You know, if he's going to face those guys, he wants them with nobody on. And here's the 1-2. Ball misses. Ball gets away from the catcher. Donahue scampers down to second base. So now Rivera stands up with a potential RBI situation. Two balls, two strikes. Abbas looks in and delivers. And there is a base hit to center field, and they may send this runner. Here comes the throw to the plate, and the East has taken the lead. 5-4 in the top of the eighth inning. So,
top of the eighth, the first lead of the game.
So Mario Rivera comes through again. Star of the game somewhat.
Now Rivera's making his case for MVP of this game.
Exactly. It's an RBI. And that pass ball looms large for sure, which got that runner to second base. And Ron Frisch is going to come out and talk to his pitcher. And for the first time tonight, the host team is trailing. And we're going to be back in just a minute. Zach Gorman steps in now with Mario Rivera at first base with two outs. Every rally that the East has put up and every run that they've scored have come with two outs, Rick.
That is quite a statistic right there.
Yeah, it's amazing. Yeah, and what a testament to their fortitude.
That's staying cool under pressure is what that is. Yeah. Not panicking, getting the job done.
If they're able to win this game, these boys will never in their lives forget this moment.
Not at all.
No matter what happens to them on Saturday, whatever happens to them on Sunday, if they end up playing on Sunday, they'll never forget this moment. Because these things don't even happen with any regularity at all during a regular season game, let alone down to your last strike in a World Series game.
Right.
You know, with your whole season, your whole tournament life, you everything on the line, and to come up with a game-tying grand slam in the last inning, that's...
Well, and no matter how this turns out, you know Patrick Burns is going to have stories to tell his grandkids.
Right. So, Gorman lines out to the second baseman. That ends the inning. However, the East put up a run. Mario Rivera with a RBI single. And they're now three outs away from advancing to the Saturday championship game. We'll be back in a minute.
Now back in the bottom of the eighth, Tyler Wood leading things off for the host team. Mile-an-hour fastball for strike number one. 1-1 is the count. Gorman dialing up all the right pitches right now. Gets ahead 1-2 on Tyler Wood. And now the East are two outs away from completing their big comeback. But first they're going to have to deal with the likes of first baseman Noah Garcia. Garcia in the tournament has had a couple of clutch hits. And manager Jim Grant is hoping he can pull one out right here.
So a swing and a miss by Noah Garcia. Count is 0-1. Excuse me, 1-1. So Zach Gorman, who briefly left the game on the mound and went back to shortstop, came back in and did a good job. That's a swinging strike three, thrown down to first base. You got to run harder. Oh. That's the second out of the inning.
And now New Jersey, one out away from facing Hawaii in the championship game.
That's right. It's going to bring to the plate. Andrew Gaskell represents the last hope for the host team. Swing and a miss, strike one.
I am just struck by the determination in Gorman's eyes.
Yeah. Yeah, he smells it. What an incredible comeback. Swing and a miss, strike two. And now the host team is down to their last strike. It's a ball outside, and the count is 2-2. Swung on and missed, and that completes the comeback. What an incredible comeback by the New Jersey team, the East Regional champions. They're celebrating on the grass.
Absolutely.
Can't blame them.
Absolutely amazing comeback.
The host team has got to be just completely deflated. Their heads are up.
They put in a great showing at this tournament. Like I said, they played shutdown defense. Nobody really expects the host team to do much of anything, and I think they turned a few heads this year.
Absolutely they did. So they got nothing to nothing to hang their heads about. They
nothing
played
at
fantastic.
All.
And that last inning just got away from them in one of the most incredible comebacks you'll ever see at any level. Congratulations to Freehold Township Little League. They're going to move on to the championship game, and they're going to face the regional champions from the West, Maui, Hawaii, on Saturday at 5 p.m. Pacific time. Rick, thanks again. It was an absolutely incredible game.
Thank you, Rick. And it's, all the games I've been here for, I have enjoyed very, very much. They've been excellent, fantastic games to watch, and to be able to sit here and call them, like you said, best seat in the house.
Absolutely. So this is going to conclude our live stream performance of this 2017 Intermediate Little League World Series in Livermore, California. We're glad everyone has joined us. We're signing off now. Pick us up on ESPN3 and ESPN2 on Saturday for the conclusion of this wonderful tournament. Have a great night, everybody. Good night. The regional champions from the West, Maui, Hawaii, on Saturday at 5 p.m. Pacific time. Rick, thanks again. It was an absolutely incredible game.
Thank you, Rick. And it's, all the games I've been here for, I have enjoyed very, very much. They've been excellent, fantastic games to watch, and to be able to sit here and call them, like you said, best seat in the house.
Absolutely. So this is going to conclude our live stream performance of this 2017 Intermediate Little League World Series in Livermore, California. We're glad everyone has joined us. We're signing off now. Pick us up on ESPN3 and ESPN2 on Saturday for the conclusion of this wonderful tournament. Have a great night, everybody. Good night.